For this project, you're going to need your H or 5mm crochet hook. You're also going to need a pair of scissors and a tapestry needle. For the feet, I just wanted to show you the difference in the yarns and the crochet hook. So with my H or 5mm crochet hook, which is the hook that we've been using, it makes this size paw with the effervesce yarn. So you can see the look of the paws if you use this crochet hook. And then if you have the red heart equivalent yarn, this is what the paw looks like when using this crochet hook. For one of the dogs, I used a smaller crochet hook. This crochet hook is the F or 4mm crochet hook, and you can see the look. This is with the effervesce yarn, and this is the difference, the size difference and look between the 2 feet. So you can decide which crochet hook that you want to use. If you would like the bigger foot, then you'd use the H or 5mm, and if you like the look of the smaller foot, then you can use your F or 4mm. And I use the same pattern for both. So you just need to switch your crochet hook if you would prefer the smaller foot. I found that this yarn worked really well. This is Yarn Bee Effervesce, and this color is black gauze. Here's a little bit more information about the yarn. There's a free pattern on the label. And here's more information about this yarn. The other yarn that I used is also by Yarn Bee Effervesce. This color is Stardust. It looks like it has the same free pattern on this one. For the nose, I just used my Craft Smart Value yarn. It's a red heart equivalent yarn. You only need a little bit of this for the nose. And here's some information on this yarn. For the tongue, I just used a little bit of my I Love This yarn. It also has a free pattern on the label, and the color is Hot Rose. It's a red heart equivalent yarn. Here's some more information about the yarn. You just need a little bit of it for the tongue. This is an exciting yarn that I'm going to show to you by Yarn Bee. It's Haute Fur. The color is Jet Set. And you can see how it has the fur look to it. And then the yarn is down the center of it. This is the black color, Jet Set. Here's some more information on the yarn. The only problem with this yarn is it's a little bit pricey. So you could use it, your coupons, if you wanted to get this yarn. And I found this yarn at Hobby Lobby. Here is the other color. This one is called Snowflake by Yarn Bee again. More information on the yarn. I show 2 different style of eyes for the dog. One of them I got from Hobby Lobby. This is the Animal Eyes 15mm from Treehouse Studios. It's the blue eye. The other one that I'm showing you is a Suncatcher Craft Eye, and it's an 18mm. I'm just going to show you the size differences. This is the 18mm Suncatcher Craft Eye. This is the 15mm blue eye from Treehouse Studio. Also, this is from Suncatcher Craft Eye. You can get a multicolored pack. So if you wanted to make one blue eye and one brown eye, this is what it would look like. The Treehouse Studio also has brown eyes if you prefer just using the same brand of eye. But for mine, I'm going to show one of the dogs with the Treehouse Studio blue eyes and then one of the dogs with the Suncatcher Craft Eye, a little bit larger brown. These are the safety latches that go on your Suncatcher Craft Eyes. And this is the safety latch that goes on the Treehouse Studio. And they both work the same to me. I like them both. The Suncatcher Craft Eyes have to be ordered online.
And I found the animal eyes from Treehouse Studio at Hobby Lobby.
You're also going to need craft stuffing. I just use an inexpensive Walmart pillow. They sell them for under $3.
I put together a little list of the different types of yarns and the different styles of border collies that I made. And I also put approximate prices so you can kind of see what each one would cost to make. My favorite has to be style 1, but I also like the style of 2, and even style 3 is not too bad. But my favorite one, of course, is style 1. Here are all of the dogs together so you can see the different styles. This first dog is style 1, and I named her Joy. She has a name tag on underneath with her name on it. And hers, see if I could find the name for you.
Here it is, and the name is Joy for hers.
And again, that's style 1. And then style 2 I also like, but I just like the fake fur that gives a real look on style 1. But here's style 2 with the effervesce yarn. You can also see the different colored eyes. This one has the blue eyes, and this one has a really pretty aqua color. This one has the painted toenails, but also has the effervesce style yarn, and I show how to make the bow if you like the way it looks with the bow. And then here is the red heart yarn. I show how to make the flower as well with the button in the center. So this is what it looks like with the red heart yarn, and she has the different colored eyes, the brown and the blue eyes, and the painted toenails. This is what the dogs look like from behind. I don't have a collar on this dog yet, the Red Heart Style 3, but this dog is going to have one, and her name is Wren. Then I have the one, this is Kate with the purple bow and her collar, and Jack with his blue collar. And then Style 1 is Joy. She's the one that's going to have the Mad Hatter hat on. She's all packaged up and ready to go to the fair. She has her Mad Hatter hat on. She's going to be a donation dog. Here is a side view. The back. And the other side. Here is a close-up of the Mad Hatter hat and the Style 1 crochet border collie.
You can see how the fake fur yarn makes it look really real. Here's a side shot of the dog. This is style one, has her Queen of Hearts backpack. Here's the back of the dog, style one dog with the hat on, the Queen of Hearts backpack, and here's the other side, and then actually you have the Queen of Hearts and the King of Hearts playing cards. The button that's holding the Queen of Hearts backpack in place, and again this is style one crochet border collie. Here is a close-up of the Mad Hatter hat that I made. The clock timepiece opens up. You can put pictures on the inside. I have four safety pins to help hold it in place, and it also has ties that you can tie a bow under the chin of the dog. You have the tea set on top that can come off. I made it so you can remove it. All the pieces are removable. The mirror included can come out as well. And then on the back, I have the little Frozen doll that looks like Alice. And then on the inside, I have all the toys. And you can just keep it closed by strapping the button onto the back. We're going to start with the white yarn, and we're going to make the snout. So we're going to start with a magic circle. So just take your yarn, you're going to drape it across your four fingers, use your thumb to stabilize, then wrap the yarn around the two middle fingers, and hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb, just like this. Then you're going to take your crochet hook, put it right under the two loops around the middle finger. You're going to bring up a loop. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for a slip knot. Then you're going to make six single crochet into the magic circle. So just take your crochet hook, go under those two loops around the middle finger, bring up a loop. You have two loops on the hook. Yarn over, turn the hook upside down, go through both of the loops for a single crochet. And then you're going to make six of them into the magic circle. Then you're going to take your forefinger and your thumb, go ahead and grasp your crochet hook and use your forefinger and thumb to hold the base of the six single crochet. Then you have these two loops on the opposite side. You're going to pull on one of them to close the center of the magic circle. If it doesn't close, let go and pull on the other one, but this one is closing. So just gently close it. You can close it more later. Just close it as much as you can. Then take that loose yarn end and pull on that. Then turn your work. We're going to start working into the first stitch in the circle. So then you take your crochet hook, go into that first stitch. You're going to bring up a loop. You have two loops on the hook. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both loops for a single crochet. Then you're going to make one more single crochet into the same stitch. And then you're going to make two single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total of 12 stitches. So that was two. And then putting two single crochet into the next stitch, which will give me a total of four. And then you're just going to keep doing that all the way around until you have a total of 12 stitches in the circle, and then come back. This is what your work should look like so far, and you have a total of 12 stitches all the way around. If you still have a little bit of an opening in the center of your magic circle, go ahead and turn your work over. And then just pull on that loose yarn end gently, and that will close up the center of the magic circle. Now we're going to start our increase rounds. So you're going to need a yarn marker. I just use one of my scraps of yarn. Just place it right where you left off. It just helps you keep track of where you are on the increase round. For the first increase round, you're going to make one single crochet into the first stitch. And then two single crochet into the second stitch. And then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. I had one person ask, what is an increase round? Basically, we're increasing the number of stitches in the round. So I'll make one more set with you. Make one single crochet into the first stitch. And then two single crochet into the second stitch. And then repeat that all the way around back to the yarn marker, and then come back. On that round, you should have completed 18 stitches total. Then you can go ahead and move your yarn marker up for the next increase round. So just place it right where you left off. For this increase round, you're going to make one single crochet into the next two stitches. And then you're going to make two single crochet into the third stitch. Then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. So one single crochet into two stitches, and then two single crochet into the third stitch. This is how your work should look so far, and you should have 24 stitches around after this round. When I refer to stitches, I mean, I'm going to show with my tapestry needle. I'm talking about here's the front loop, here's the back loop, and the tapestry needle is through one of the stitches. So that is here, right after my yarn marker, is the first stitch, second stitch, third stitch, and that's how you're going to count them all the way around. Now you're going to take your yarn marker up. This time we're not going to be doing an increase round, so all of your stitches all the way around should remain the same for each round. So for each round now, for four rounds, you're going to have 24 stitches in each round. And you're just going to make one single crochet into every stitch around. So one single crochet in every stitch. When you reach the yarn marker, come back and I'll show you how we move on to complete four rounds of one single crochet in every stitch. I finished making one single crochet into every stitch around, and I'm back to the yarn marker. So you should have a total of 24 stitches still, because we did not make an increase round, meaning we didn't increase the number of stitches. And when I say decrease round, that means that we're decreasing the number of stitches, but we haven't gotten to that yet. Later on, I'll be showing you some decrease rounds. But for this round, it's very important for a beginner that you maintain your number of stitches. So unfortunately, as a beginner, you'll need to count your stitches, because that's where I found the beginners have the most trouble. If you don't get the right number of stitches, your work won't come out right. So it's better to catch it now than later. So you just finished your 24 stitches in that round. Since we're making four rounds of one single crochet in every stitch, you're just going to keep going until you've counted four rounds of one single crochet in every stitch. So far, the yarn marker shows us that we've only completed one round. This is how my work looks so far. You can see how you're forming a cup for the snout. And you should have finished 1, 2, 3, 4 rounds of one single crochet in every stitch. Now we're going to make another increase round. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up to where we left off. For this increase round, you're going to make one single crochet into 3 stitches. And then you're going to make 2 single crochet into the 4th stitch. Then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker, and then come back. You should have finished 30 stitches around for that increase round. Then go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. Now we're going to make one single crochet into every stitch around, and that means that every time you reach the yarn marker, just like last time, we're only going to have 30 stitches for that round, because remember, we made an increase round. This is how your work should look now for the snout. And you should have finished 1, 2, 3, 4 rounds of one single crochet in every stitch. Then we're going to make a slip stitch. So we're finished now with the snout for now. You're going to take your crochet hook, you're going to go into the next stitch over, you're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and then bring the yarn through both loops on the hook for a slip stitch. Then you can go ahead and finish off, just yarn over. Actually, we're not going to finish off. We're going to continue the white strip that goes up for the dog's head. Now, after you finish your slip stitch, just turn your work. And we're going to work into the next stitch over. So we're going to be working into that next stitch. Just take your crochet hook, go into that next stitch over, and you're going to bring up a loop, make a single crochet. So that's one single crochet, and you're going to make one single crochet into a total of 4. So the next 3 stitches, we're going to make one single crochet. So we have a total of 4. It's 2. Three. And 4. then we can make a slip stitch into the next stitch. Then you can chain one, turn your work, then you're going to work into the next stitch over, and the next stitch. The next stitch, so now you have a total of 4 stitches. That first chain 1 and then 2, 3, 4. So that row that we just finished counted as 1. We're going to make 2 more rows exactly the same. So you're going to chain 1, turn your work. You're going to make a single crochet into the next stitch. Single crochet into the next stitch. And then single crochet into that last stitch. That last stitch is a little tricky. But just get into that last stitch and make your single crochet. And then we're going to make 1 more. So chain 1, turn your work, and again that first chain 1 sometimes a little tricky to get into that stitch. This is how your work is looking. You can see how you're starting to build that white stripe that goes up and over the dog's head. Now we're going to increase the size of the white strip. So you're going to chain 1, turn your work. This time you're going to make a single crochet into the same stitch. So you're going to work right into the same stitch to make a single crochet. So take your crochet hook, go into that same stitch, make a single crochet, then go into the next stitch, make a single crochet, next stitch, single crochet, and then in the last stitch you're going to make 2 single crochet into the same stitch. And all we're doing is increasing the size of the white strip and making extra stitches. So you can see how we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 stitches after completing that row. Now you're going to chain 1, turn your work. This time we're not going to work in the same stitch, so you're not going to work into that base or same stitch. You're going to go into the next stitch over. So that first chain 1 counts as 1 stitch. You're going to go into the next stitch over, make 1 single crochet, next stitch, 1 single crochet, and you're going to repeat that all the way across. There's the 4th, here's the 5th, And then don't forget the last stitch. Sometimes it looks like you're done, but remember we're only on the fifth stitch and you need the sixth stitch. So you go into that last stitch, make your single crochet, and we're going to repeat this until we've completed 10 rows. So that counts as your first row. Chain one, turn your work, and you're going to repeat the same thing, go into the next stitch, second single crochet, third single crochet, fourth, fifth, and sixth. And you're going to keep repeating this until you've completed 10 rows of one single crochet into every stitch. So chain one and turn for your third row. And then come back when you've completed 10 rows. This is how your work should look after completing 10 rows of one single crochet into every stitch. And this is how my work looks so far. The snout, and then the white strip that's going to go onto the top of the head. When you're finished, we're going to go ahead and finish off. So you just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and bring enough yarn through to sew the strip onto the dog. Just take your scissors and cut the yarn, and that creates a knot at the end, and then when you sew it in place, it helps to keep it even sturdier. So I tried to finish off a long strand for sewing as much as possible, and it's less yarn ends to bury at the end. Now I'm going to show you how to make the nose for the dog. I just use my Red Heart equivalent black yarn for that. Just take the yarn and you're going to form a loop with your yarn. So just take and form a loop. Then you're going to put your crochet hook right through the loop and then hold the base of the loop with your middle finger and your thumb. Then you're just going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, go through that loop for a slip knot. Then you can just pull on that loose yarn end and that creates a knot. And then you can cinch the loop around the crochet hook. Then we're going to make a chain. We're going to make a chain of four. So just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, go through the loop for one chain, two, three, four. Then you're going to take your crochet hook, go into the second chain from the hook. So the second chain from the hook. Just take your crochet hook and go into that space. Then you're going to bring up a loop. And we're going to make a single crochet. Then you're going to go into the next stitch over and make a single crochet. Then in the last stitch, you're going to make three single crochet in the same stitch. So you're going to go into that last stitch, and make three single crochet in the same stitch. And at the same time, you're turning your work because we're going to start working on the opposite side to work in a circle. So now, after completing the three single crochet, you're going to be on the opposite side. So we just finished working on this side. Now we're going to work on the other side. And you can also work behind your loose yarn end. So now you're going to go into the next stitch over. Go into the next stitch over, go behind the loose yarn end, bring up a loop, make a single crochet, and then you're going to go into the next stitch. And in this stitch, you're going to make 3 single crochet in the same stitch. Then you can go ahead and cut your loose yarn end. This is how my work looks so far. Now you can get a yarn marker to help show where you are.
I'm going to use
my pink yarn, scrap yarn, to show where I am. And you just place it right where you left off. Now you're going to go into the next stitch over, and we're going to make 1 single crochet in every stitch around back to the yarn marker. So 1 single crochet in every stitch all the way around. You can see how it's forming a circle and forming the crochet nose for the dog. Then my last stitch right before the yarn marker. Then you can go ahead and take the yarn marker out because we are done. Now you're just going to make a slip stitch into the next stitch over. So take your crochet hook, go into the next stitch over. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and bring the yarn through both loops on the hook for a slip stitch. Then you can yarn over and bring the yarn through, bring enough yarn through to sew the nose onto the dog. This is what my nose looks like, and you can decide which side you want to show. And don't worry about the holes there, because we're going to stuff it with black yarn before sewing it onto the snout. Now you can take a little bit of a black yarn and just kind of bunch it up, and then just place it right into the center of the nose. Then you can see how you have a nice nose that you can sew onto the snout. Now you want to take your tapestry needle and put it onto the long end that you left for sewing, and you want to center your snout, your nose, onto the snout, the front of the snout. Then you're going to take your tapestry needle and just sew it in place. Here is the center of my magic circle as a guide to help in placement of the nose. Then you're just going to take and go in and out along the base of the nose all the way around, sewing it in place. This is what my nose looks like after I've sewn it in place. Make sure that it doesn't come off, that it's sewed securely. Now I'm going to show you how to make the mouth. Now just take your tapestry needle with some black yarn, the same black yarn that you used to make the nose. Then you're going to come in from the inside of the snout and come out directly down the center of the nose. So right down the center of the side, not the center of the middle of the nose, but the center along the bottom of the nose. And you leave enough yarn on the inside for tying a knot. Then you're going to go straight down and back in. Then you're going to come up on the side to form the smile. Go back in where you came out. You can see how I made half a smile. Now you're going to make the exact same thing on the opposite side. Make sure that you're equal. And then go back in and then tie a knot on the inside. Now you're going to get your pink yarn. We're going to make the tongue. You're going to start the same way as you did for the snout. You're going to drape the yarn across your four fingers and use your thumb to stabilize. We're going to make the magic circle. Wrap the yarn around your two middle fingers and then hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. Just like this. Now you're going to take your crochet hook, go under the two loops around the middle fingers. You're going to bring up a loop. Then you're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, go through the loop for a slip knot. Then we're going to make one single crochet into the magic circle. For this next stitch, you're going to make a half double crochet. So you're going to yarn over. You're going to go into the magic circle. You're going to bring up a loop. Now you have three loops on your hook. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through all three loops for a half double crochet. Now we're going to make three double crochet into the magic circle. So you're going to yarn over, go into the magic circle, bring up a loop, three loops on the hook, you're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through two of the loops. Now you have two loops remaining. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through the two remaining loops for a double crochet. Now you're going to make two more double crochet into the magic circle. Then you're going to make a half double crochet. So yarn over, bring up a loop, yarn over, go through all three. Then the last stitch is a single crochet. Now you're going to hold your crochet hook, take your forefinger and your thumb, grab the base of all of those stitches. You have the two loops on the opposite side. You're going to pull on one of them. If it doesn't close, let go and pull on the other one. This one's closing. Just close it gently. Then take your loose yarn end and pull on that. Then you can see how you have a tongue. Now what you're going to do is we're going to slip stitch and finish off. So you're going to take your crochet hook, you're going to go into the center of the magic circle. You're going to yarn over and bring the yarn through the center of the magic circle and the loop on the hook for a slip stitch. Then you can go ahead and finish off. Just yarn over and pull enough yarn through to sew the tongue onto the dog. Now you can take and cinch down that long end that you left for sewing. You can also pull on that loose yarn end to close that center of the magic circle. Then you have your tongue. You can go ahead and tie a knot for extra strength, making sure it won't come undone. Just a couple times will work. Now your tongue is ready to be sewn on to the dog. Then you want to take and place the tongue right beneath the smile of the dog. Make sure you don't cover the smile with the tongue. You still want to be able to see the smile. And then just line it up, center it where you want it, and leave the flap of the tongue unsewn. You only want to sew at the base of the tongue. This is what my tongue looks like after I've sewn it on, and you can see how you can still lift it up. Now you're going to get your fuzzy black effervesce yarn. We're going to make the head. We're going to start with the magic circle. You're going to take your crochet hook, just like we've done before. You're going to bring up a loop. Yarn over for your slip knot. Now you're going to make 6 single crochet into the magic circle. Then take your forefinger and your thumb, just hold the base of the 6 single crochet, and then you have those 2 loops again right across from the center or from your stitches, and just pull on one of them, and again if it doesn't close you can take and pull on the other one. Then take your loose yarn in and pull on that, then turn your work. You're going to go into that first stitch, and again you're going to make 2 single crochet into the same stitch, and you're going to make 2 single crochet in every stitch around until you have a total of 12, just like we did for the snout, and then come back. Now we're going to start the increase rounds. We're going to be increasing all the way up to 1 in 5 and then 2 single crochet into the 6th stitch. The first thing you're going to do is just take your yarn marker, place it right where you left off. For the first increase round, you're going to make 1 single crochet into the first stitch. And then 2 single crochet into the 2nd stitch. And then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. And then come back. You should have completed 18 stitches for that round. Then go ahead and move your yarn marker up. For this increase round, you're going to make one single crochet into two stitches. And then two single crochet into the third stitch. And then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. That round should have had 24 stitches total all the way around. Then go ahead and move your yarn marker up for the third increase round. You're going to make one single crochet into three stitches. And then two single crochet into the fourth stitch. And repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. You should notice that on that last round, your stitches are increasing by 6 stitches each round as you're working. So now we're going to move up the yarn marker, and you guessed it, for this increase round, you're going to make one single crochet into 4 stitches and then two single crochet into the 5th stitch. Now for our last increase round, one single crochet into 5 stitches and then two single crochet into the 6th stitch. So I finished 42 stitches for that round, that last increase round. Now you're going to take your yarn marker and move it up, and you're only going to make one single crochet in every stitch for 14 rounds. So each round, every time you reach your yarn marker, should only have 42 stitches. So if you have more or less than that, then you put too many stitches in. So only one single crochet in every stitch around until you've completed 14 rounds, and then come back. Now you should have finished 14 rounds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and your work should look like this. And I just want to show you that the body is going to be made the exact same way that you made the head. The only difference is for the body, you're going to make 18 rounds of one single crochet in every stitch. So 18 rounds for the body, but the rest is made the exact same way as the head. And for the head, you're going to stop after 14 rounds. So I'll come back to the body later, and when I come back to the body, it will be at this point. So that way you'd be able to make everything the exact same way up to the 18th round, and then I'll continue the body with you later. But for now, we're going to finish the head. So you're going to take your crochet hook after you finish those 14 rounds, and we're going to make a slip stitch into the next stitch over. So you just yarn over and pull the yarn through both loops on the hook for a slip stitch. Then you're going to finish off. Just yarn over and pull enough yarn through so that we can attach it later and tie a knot. It's just going to be easier for us to finish off now because we want to make the face, and a face is just a lot easier to make when you have an opening to go inside, and then I'll show you how to close it after we're finished making the face of the dog. Now you're going to place your eyes, and how I placed my eyes is I went from the top. So the center of your magic circle, and you're going to count out, here's the first round, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So right under that 10th round is where I place the first eye on the front, and then here's where we finished off, so I leave that in the back. After you place one eye, you're going to count 6 stitches over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Actually, you're going to count 7 and then place the other eye. That way you have 6 stitches showing. So 6 stitches between the eyes. Once you're happy with your eye placement, make sure that they're on the same round, that they're not crooked. Then you can place your safety latches onto the back. Be very careful, because once you get these safety latches on, they're not coming off. So make sure your eyes are where you want them to be before you secure them with the safety latches. And you can see that those safety latches really make them secure. Now you're going to want your craft stuffing. And this stuffing is for the snout. The stuffing that I use is just from a Walmart pillow, because they sell large pillows there for under $3. So that's very inexpensive for the stuffing. And if you like to make amigurumi, you want as cheap of a stuffing as possible. Then you can just take and put the stuffing inside of the snout. And then I'm going to show you how to sew the snout onto the head. Now you're going to get your tapestry needle with the white colored yarn, and we're going to sew the snout in place. So you're going to take your snout, and you want to have a little strip of black showing around the eye. So you're going to want to position the snout so that you have the nose straight and you have the snout in position. So the funny thing is, the crochet part of it is actually the easiest part, but the hard part is positioning everything and sewing it in place so that it's not crooked. So the first thing you want to do is, after you have it positioned, take your tapestry needle from the inside and sew this little strip first. So I just sewed just this part of the strip. I'll sew the top part of the strip later. We're positioning the snout first. So after you sew that portion, then you're going to take and position the bottom part of the snout. And you want the bottom part of the snout to be in line with the bottom part of the head. You want to make sure that your nose and your tongue are straight. And then you're just going to take your tapestry needle, even though your yarn is still up here where you're sewing, it doesn't matter because it's going to be on the inside anyway. So you're just going to come with your yarn and come out. After you line up, make sure everything is straight, and then come out from the inside and sew along the bottom. So you can see how I stretched the yarn a little bit on the back, but that doesn't matter because it's on the inside. And then you're just going to sew the bottom in place of the snout. And I just found this easier so that I can position the nose and the mouth easier and get the strip where I want it and make sure that that's in place. Then after you finish sewing along the bottom, then you can finish sewing the sides of the snout in place and then come back. You can see how I'm sewing in and out right along the border of the snout and sewing it in place. This is how my snout looks so far. You can see how it's straight. I have the little black line on both sides. Now you're ready to sew down the white strip. And you should have a long end that you left for sewing. This is not going to be very long, so I'm probably going to have to add more white yarn. If you don't have a long yarn end, then just get some white yarn, and then you're going to position the white stripe how you want it on the dog. Then you can take and just sew it in place. So you just go in and out and sew the white lining in place. And then when you run out, just get some more white yarn and tie a knot on the inside of the dog's head. This is how the head looks on mine after I've sewn it in place. Now you're going to set the head of the dog aside and we're going to make the ears. Just take your black yarn and you're going to fold it over on itself to form a loop. I'm using the effervesce yarn for the ears, the same as the main part of the head of the dog. Then put your crochet hook right through the loop. You're going to hold the base of the loop with your middle finger and your thumb. You're going to make a slip knot, so just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for a slip knot. Then pull on that loose yarn and that cinches a knot. Then you could pull the loop a little bit snugger around the crochet hook. And we're going to make a chain. So we're going to make a chain of 11. So you should have a chain of 11. Then you're going to take your crochet hook, go into the second chain from the hook. You're going to bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both for a single crochet. Then you're going to make one single crochet in every stitch back across. Then I have two more stitches. This is how your work should look so far. Now you're just going to make a chain of one. We're going to move up to the next row, so chain one. Then you're going to turn your work. You're not going to work into that first base of that first chain one. You're going to go into the next stitch over. So take your crochet hook, go into that next stitch over, and you're going to make a single crochet. Then you're going to make one single crochet in every stitch back across. And then come back. You should have reached the end. This is what my work looks like so far. And you should have completed 10 stitches. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 stitches. Then you're going to chain 1. To move up to the next row. Then turn your work and you're going to repeat that same pattern. One single crochet into the next stitch over and one single crochet in every stitch back across and then come back. So this is what my work looks like so far, and so far you should have straight edges. for now, we're going to form a triangle later, but right now we want straight edges. And we're going to make one more row following this pattern. So you should have finished 10 stitches again. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So make sure that you only have 10 stitches. Then you can chain one, turn your work, and this will be our last row with this pattern, and then we're going to start forming the triangular ear. You're going to go into the next stitch over just like you did for the previous rows, and you're going to make one single crochet in every stitch back across and then come back. This is how your work should look so far. You can see how it's making a perfect rectangle with the straight sides on the edges. And you should have finished 10 stitches. Now we're going to form the triangle portion of the ear. So on this next row, you're not going to chain one. You're just going to turn your work. Then you're going to work into the next stitch over, and you're going to make a single crochet. And then you're going to make one single crochet in every stitch back across and then come back. So for that last row, you should have 9 stitches on that last row. Then you're going to turn your work. And again, you're just going to go into the next stitch over and make one single crochet in every stitch back across and then come back. This is how my work looks so far. And on that last row, you should have had 8 stitches. So you can see how it's getting smaller and smaller. That's what we want, because now we're forming the triangular or top portion of the ear. Then, after you finish that last single crochet in the last stitch, you're going to turn your work again. You're going to go into the next stitch over, and you're going to keep repeating this until you get to the point of the ear. You should have only 2 stitches left. I'm going to work it with you though. I'm going to go ahead and just work the rest of this with you so you can see what I'm doing. Now I'm going to turn my work, go into the next stitch over, and I'm just going to keep repeating this, and it's going to keep getting smaller and smaller until I'm at the point of the ear or the point of the triangle. You can see how I'm forming a triangular ear now. It's getting smaller and smaller. Now, when I turn my work, I have 1 stitch left. I'm going to slip stitch into that stitch and then I'm going to go ahead and finish off. And I'm going to go ahead and pull excess yarn through to sew the ear onto the dog. Then you can see how you have a perfect triangular tip. And you're going to need two of these for the dog ears. After you made two ears for your dog, then just take your tapestry needle and put it onto the long end that you left for sewing at the point of the ear. Then bring the yarn through that point. And you're just going to take small stitches and bring it down to the corner to sew it in place. So you're just kind of weaving it through. That just gives extra strength to the dog so it doesn't fall apart easily and you don't have a lot of loose yarn ends. We have the other loose yarn end that we're going to bury into the head of the dog. And then once you have the yarn at the bottom of the ear, it's ready to be sewn on. When you sew it onto the dog, you want to have the side of the ear where the ear flops easily forward. You don't want it to be flopping towards the back. So see which way the ear flops forward, and then that's the way that's going to face forward on the dog. Thank you.